In the earlier part, we have seen about the formal and informal sector. But it is not possible immediate to reduce the impact, the dominance of the informal sector. To come out from that, some help groups are working in the rural region. In urban region also, it's are working. But in rural region, it's are mostly working. Help, self-help groups for the poor. Bachat Gut, in short, we say it. These are the self-help groups. The formation of the Bachat Gut or the self-help group, you know. But then also we are going to discuss here. People, different people, mostly ladies, come together, collect their share and makes the capital, and this capital they provide those who are in a need. Very easily these groups are working there, and it is a way to lift the people who are in need in our surrounding. About it we will see here. In the previous section we have seen that poor household are still depend on informal sources of credit. What is it so? Banks are not present everywhere in rural India. This picture we knew. Even when they are present, getting a loan from a bank is much more difficult than taking a loan from informal sources. If you want to go to the bank to take the loan, documentation is there, then collateral is there. So that things are needing to complete, and people are not ready to complete that documentation, or it need time. People immediately need the money. So automatically these people turns toward the informal sector. Because in informal sources, there is no need to give the document or to give something there. It is not needing time also. Whenever you will go, the person will be ready to give you. As we saw for Mega, bank loan requires proper documents and collateral. We have seen with the case of Mega, absence of collateral is one of the major reasons which prevents the poor from getting bank loans. The poor are not having collateral safety to give to the banks. That is why banks are not giving loan to them. This is the main obstacle to the poor to get loan from the banks. Informal lenders such as money lenders, on the other hand, know the borrower personally and hence are often willing to give a loan without collateral. The money lenders knew he mostly belongs from the same village, familiar person. He gives very easily to him the loan. The borrower can, if necessary, approach the money lender even without repaying earlier loans. However, the money lenders charge very high rates of interest, keep no record of the transaction, and harass the poor borrower. Then also the people goes to the money lender. In recent years, people have tried out some newer ways of providing loans to the poor. This was the old way. Now the new ways are came in a recent years to complete the needs, the economical needs. The idea is to organize rural poor, in particular women, into small self-help groups. Yes, SHGs or pool, they pool, collect their savings. A typical SHG has 15 to 20 members. The self-help groups are having near of 15 to 20 members, usually belonging to one neighborhood. They mostly belonging in the same area, who meet and save regularly. Regularly they meet and saving money. Saving per member varies from rupees 25 to 100 or more, depending on the ability of the people to save. The saving, it depends on the person, the ability of the persons, how much he can save. He can save there. Members can take small loan from the group itself to meet their needs. The members can take the small loan from the group to complete his or her need. He's also, because nowadays the gents also making the self-help groups. The group charge charges interest on this loan, but this is still less than what the money lender charges. The group is also charging interest on the money, but these interest charges are less than the money lender. After a year or two, if the group is regular in a saving, it becomes eligible for availing loan from the bank. When the group will work 1-3 years regularly, so bank also provides loan to this group. Loan is sanctioned in the name of group. When they are taking loan from the bank, it is sanctioned gate on the name of the group. This group is making opening account in the bank, and in the account also the remaining saving these people are keeping. And when they need in a taking loan, the bank provides loan to them also. Loan is sanctioned in the name of the group and is meant to create self-employment opportunities for the member. This is the way to create the self-employment, reduce the dependence on the informal sector, or to work in the other's farm or anywhere. For instance, small loans are provided to the members for releasing mortgages land. If one is made the land mortgage, that land is also released through it. For meeting working capital needs, buying seeds, fertilizers, raw material like bamboo and cloth, the capital, working capital also completed through the self-help group. For housing material, for acquiring assets like sewing machine, handloom, cattle, etc. So the member can use any way the loan taken by the self-help group. In this way, self-help groups are helping to reduce the poverty or to stand capital to complete the needs, working capital or their own capital which is kept as a mortgage to be granted. The purpose amount interest to be charged, repayment schedule. The repayment schedule is also there. Also, it is the group which is responsible for the repayment of the loan. If the one the loan is taken on the name of the bank, so then on the name of the self-help group, that self-help group is responsible to repay it. Any case of non-repayment of loan by any one member is followed up seriously by other members in the group. Because of this feature, banks are willing to lend to the poor women when organized in SHGs, even though they have no collateral as such. Thus, the SHG help borrowers overcome. Thus, the SHGs help borrowers overcome the problem of lack of collateral. In this way, the self-help group are helping to the members to come out from the needs of the loan, needs of the collateral. They can get timely loan for a variety of purpose and at a reasonable interest rate. The interest rate is also reasonable. Moreover, SHG are the building blocks of organization of the rural poor. This is a very good. These are working in the poor region, in the rural poor region. They are building the economy of the country. Not only does it help women to become financially self-reliant, they are not just making self-reliant to the financially, but the regular meeting of the group provide a platform to discuss and act on a variety of social issues such as health, nutrition, domestic violence, etc. When these people regularly meet, they discuss different issues and try to solve the problems in the region or in the field, in the life of the women. This is a picture which is shown here, how the self-help group meeting is held here, conducted. They are discussing. These kind of meetings are there. This is the SHG. One is working in the rural region. The women are came together and talking, discussing something. In this way, they works here. The example of the Grameen Bank of Bangladesh is given here in our book. How the Grameen Bangladesh Bank is working there, and it provides loan to the people who are in need. And it helped to lift up the economically weaker section in the Bangladesh. Grameen Bank of Bangladesh is one of the biggest success stories in reaching the poor to meet their credit needs at reasonable rates. This is the example given here. If like these banks are started in India also, then it will help to come out the poor people from the poverty. So in this chapter we have seen the money as a medium of exchange, why money, importance of the money, why should we use money to exchange. Then we have seen different forms of money, working of the banks, credit, terms of credit, and the two sectors of the credit, formal sector and informal sector. Then self-help group. About all things we have studied, and we came to know, to uplift the Indian economy, we should focus on the rural region and formal sector of the credit.